Hello and welcome to another video. First of all, happy new years, early, late, whatever, but better late than never, or better early than never. I'm Lucien Rowan, and Calibrato requested a tutorial for Windows Server 2008.2, of course the standard 64-bit version. Of course, you may like and subscribe this video at the end if you want to, either on YouTube or on Odyssey, maybe both. Thanks for the 6 subscribers on EmuGUI YouTube and on Odyssey, the 1 subscriber, thanks. And thanks for the 56 stars on GitHub, I really appreciate all that. Oh, 10 porks. Of course you have to download everything separately, there are audio tutorials for that. If I have to remake them, please comment. Otherwise, you find them on my main channel, Lucien Rowan. Anyway, let's get started. First of all, you have to open EmuGUI. The latest version at the time of this recording is EmuGUI 1.2.1.5511. So, if there's an update coming up, it might change how EmuGUI behaves as well. Click on New Virtual Machine. Type in a suitable name, in this case Windows Server 2008 R2. Select the 64-bit x86-64, click Next. For the machine, let QEMU decide. For the CPU, it depends. For KVM, select the host one. The others can select QEMU64. For the RAM, I suggest that to give at least 4 GB. However, how much you can give also depends on the RAM amount of RAM you have. In this case, I have 12 GB. Go to your Windows system information or Linux system information, whatever, and check how much RAM you have before proceeding. Click Next. Create a new virtual hard drive and browse. And we'll type in win.sfr2008r2.img. VHD5 formats. Apparently, at least if one the VM runs on Windows, there are problems with the Qcode2 file format. The raw format pre-assigns the space on your hard drive but doesn't have these issues, so I recommend that. The other file formats are still up for testing. Of course you can test them if your space isn't enough and then tell me if it works or not, then I'll investigate. Anyway, select gigabytes, we're gonna need at least 40 gigabytes, anything below doesn't work. Okay, maybe 50. For the hard drive controller, we'll let QEMU decide. For the VGA, select the standard VGA. For the network, we'll leave it to the E1000. For the mouse, just select the USB mouse. Click Next. Click Next again, leave everything empty. And for the sound card, if you really want sound, select the Intel HDA. But it's hard server, so I'll leave it to Intel HDA. For CPU cores, I usually recommend 2 if you have a quad core or more. However, I only have a dual core processor, sorry for that, so I can only give 1. Select the... It doesn't matter. Just select your keyboard layout or leave it to US. I do German. Next. Click Next again. We don't need any of these. For the acceleration, it depends. On Linux, I recommend KVM if it's supported. Same with Windows. If any of these are supported, please take those or one of those. However, my PC is too old, so I go with TCG and we can leave the rest as is. Click Next. Add USB support, very important. Select USB EHCI and we don't need any additional arguments and click Finish. It will take up to 10 seconds until the VM shows up on this list and there it is. Click Start Virtual Machine and select the CD-ROM. Of course I won't show you how to download it. So this is our VR build. We'll boot from D and leave the use RTC option unchecked. If you're using an older version of EmuGUI, either update or set to system. Start the VM. And this command line is actually useful in case it doesn't work. Now the VM is booting. Of course, it should load the files first. Just a little boot. Doesn't matter how long it takes. This is simulation. It will take a little bit longer than on VMware VirtualBox. Of course, in cases like these, I'd admit if there's something to take into account. For the language to install, of course it depends. Here in this case it's English, but it can also be German, it can be French, it can be... I don't care. As long as you can follow this tutorial, you're good to go. Time and currency format, I'll leave it to English United States. And for keyboard and or input methods, I'll select German. And then we're going to install this thing now. Wait for setup to load. Ah, there we are. Of course, it depends on what you want to do which edition you want to test or whatever. In my case, I'm going to do the full installation of Windows Server 2008 R2 Standard Edition. But of course, you can also install Server Core, but I recommend the full installation for the average user. Click Next. Of course, you must accept the license agreement. Click Next. Custom. And we'll install it on the unallocated space. Click Next. And we're almost there. Alright, that's all the information our computer, our VM here needs. Our VM will restart several times during the installation, of course. Deal with it. We're going to let this thing sit. Oh, we can restart now. And there's an important thing to say. Do not press anything on your keyboard. Otherwise, you're going to boot back into the ISO file. That's what we do not want. We want to boot into the virtual hard drive we created. Therefore, do not press anything. Okay, we're back and the VM is being restarted again and again. Do not press anything on your keyboard. Our setup is preparing your computer for first use. Or your VM. There we are. We have the error. The user's password must be changed before logging in on the first time. Click OK. Create a new password. And of course it must be a strong password. After your password has been changed, you're being greeted with the welcome screen. If you're forgetful or something, I really recommend writing it down on a piece of paper or something. And oh. This issue was also on Windows 7 lately. Probably a QEMU issue. I'm sorry. There are a lot of memory issues right now. And now, just wait for the desktop to load. And hope it works at all. And there we are, finally. This was it. I hope you liked it. Which system should I do next? Answer this question in the comments if you want to. Goodbye. See you next time.